When parents are exploring neurofeedback for their children, common questions they ask me are, can they train their children with neurofeedback at home? And how many sessions will their child need? So to answer the first question about whether you can do neurofeedback at home, you need to look at the kind of neurofeedback that you're exploring doing. So the first generation of neurofeedback, called protocol or linear neurofeedback, which requires a brain mapping or QEEG to be done before training begins, those systems require people to come in and do the sessions in office. The next generation of neurofeedback, called dynamical neurofeedback, the NeurOptimal system being the one that's on the market today, that system is fully automated. And so it is designed to be used at home, and it's very easy to use and have successful sessions in a home setting. The next question is, how many sessions will my child need? And the answer is, it depends. It depends on a number of factors, including how many sessions are done and over what time frame, the lifestyle of the child, and whether or not there are any underlying health issues. But in general, children do very well with neurooptimal brain training because children have so many unassigned neurons, meaning that their brains are much more ready for change than the adult brain. So with neurooptimal, which is brain training, we're teaching the brain to function differently, specifically teaching the brain to use data from the present moment to decide what to do next, rather than just habitual information. And so because of that, children in general respond very well. And typically children who train at home over a period of 2 to 3 months with multiple sessions per week do very well with the training. Lifestyle factors that can influence include what their diet is like. So how much whole foods do they eat versus processed foods and sugars? Whether they get exercise, whether they get enough sleep, whether their home environment is safe and less chaotic. Other factors are health issues. So children who have underlying health issues may experience delays in seeing results from the training because those organic issues, such as children who have food allergies, that may interfere with how quickly the results are seen.